Sports Gaming Universe.
And welcome back, everybody. Matt Vaskirjan prepping you for tonight's AAA PCL action. But before we get to the ballgame, let's have a look at the Bowman Prospect Spotlight. Champ Klein will be our focus. He's coming off a very nice game in which he racked up four hits and just looked dialed in at the plate.
Yeah, anytime you get yourself four base knocks in a game, you're doing something right. You might have gotten a couple of gifts in terms of good pitches to hit, but, you know, it's not about the pitches you get, it's what you do with them. And from what I saw, the balls were flying all over the yard off his bat. That performance was big for his team, and I'm sure they're hoping he can do it again in this one.
Okay, Eric, Steve, and I are ready for baseball, and we'll have it for you next on the show.
Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and after that nice introduction, we are back with the Champ Klein Road to the Show series here in MLB 14, the show on the PS4. Look at Champ Klein tearing up AAA in his first couple appearances. Now, obviously, things will come back down to normal, and he'll start getting out a little bit more, but right now, he's tearing the cover off the ball, and that continues right here with a shot to center field, left center. It is going to play to runner, maybe? Yes. Run comes home, and it is an RBI double for Champ Klein. He gets 20 points right there and continues his torrid hitting streak. Look at that. Shoots it right past the shortstop, who, I don't know, looked like he thought maybe that ball wasn't hit as hard as it was or misjudged it or something, because I was kind of expecting him to try to make a play, and he did not. So Champ comes up for another at-bat, and he is 1-for-2 at this point, as he must have been retired in the second at-bat. But here's his third go-round. He's going to settle in and look for a pitch, and oh, he gets it. He knows he crushed this one. Right center field, and it's gone.
Whammy!
Champ Klein delivers the two-run homer to right center, and there you go. He gets to circle the bases once again after that whammy. So he gets 32 points, no doubter. Two RBI, obviously it's a two-run homer. And Champ Klein will treat us to another home run replay. Let's see it right here as he's able to pull this pitch 412 feet into the night sky. Look at those awesome reflections off of the light banks. Oh, man. The graphics are so sweet in this game. All right, so 4-2. Base is loaded here. Oh, we got to track this down. This is big. Runner is going to tag up and score to make it 4-3, but Champ at least tracked down that ball and got it back in. So he does his job making the catch. Bases are loaded, so we get the sack fly, but Champ is coming back up to do some more damage. And before he does, we see this replay again. Oh, nice look at his swing there and his reaction to that one getting taken well out of here, 400 and some feet. 412, was it? Yeah. Drilled it. Let's see if he can repeat the performance. They need an insurance run, and that one's hit fairly hard as well, but right at the second baseman, so no go right there. He'll have his two hits, and I think that's where things will end, but the Storm Chasers do win 7-3, so all is good on the day. Champ Klein gets congratulated by his manager for a job well done. So he's now hitting at a 692 clip, just 13 at-bats, but 9 hits and 13 at-bats, two of those being homers, 5 RBI. Look at the slugging percentage. Everything looking good for Champ Klein in his first handful of games at the AAA level, doing even better than he did at AA at this point. Well, that's kind of hard to say. He had a 4-home-run game at one point. So here he comes up against Round Rock, and looking to continue this pace. He's got to have an off game sooner or later, right? Yeah, well, we're waiting for it. I wouldn't be surprised if today's the day. 1-0 Round Rock. Oh, they're going to say he held up. He was really close to striking out there. He's already worked a bunch of pitches. It's 2-2. He's going to foul that one off. Okay, another 2-2 pitch. He finds that it's a bit high. He's going to let that go. That's ball three. He's now got a full count. Let's see what he can do with this. Fouls another pitch off. He's hanging in there, seeing a lot of pitches, making the pitcher really work. Another 3-2 pitch. This one is fouled off to the right-hand side. over the first base dugout. Still 3-2. Look at that. 10 pitches he's seen. This will be pitch number 11. And did he hold up? Yes, he works a walk. 28 points for a 10-pitch at-bat. I think that was an 11-pitch at-bat. They already showed pitch 10 on that pitch track. Oh, that's interesting. Must not go up to 11 pitches. Maybe 10 pitches is the best they'll reward you for. He makes this catch out in left field and gets some more points for his fielding efforts as he is doing fairly solidly out there. This is not going to help his cause. That is a ground ball double play, and even that is going to yield him some points because he was able to see 5 pitches in that at bat, so he gets 15 points. Things going well for Champ even when he's not doing things well statistically. There's another fly out to left field, and he'll get another 7 points for his fielding. Man, he's racking it up today. Nice. So it's still a 1-0 game. They're down in the 8th inning. They really need to break through here. He waits for a breaking ball, and he gets that up the middle base hit. So he will finally get on base with a hit. He got on base with the walk before, but this is his first hit of the game. Will they be able to get a run home, or will they get shut out here? That's the question. Well, they get shut out 4-0. Champ does a nice job looking at a lot of pitches, worked that walk. That was very patient of him. None of my hitters really tend to do that because I myself am not patient as a hitter up there, but that was a work of art as far as I'm concerned because I don't often do that. That one pleased me just as much as hitting a home run. So he's hitting 625 after that game. Comes down a little bit, but it's still an awfully gaudy number right there. So as we look to get in another game action, we've got a trade. Hold up. Okay, it's not for Champ Kind, so that's good news. He's not on the move. We've got pitchers going back and forth between the Royals and Cubs. So Edwin Jackson is on the move and some other pitchers in that deal. But no Champ Kind move, so that is a good thing. At least if you are a fan of the Royals and hoping he works up through the organization. So here we go with another game against Round Rock. And Champ Kind looking to yet again come in and crush some pitches. Will he be able to do that, or will this be the game they finally shut him down? It's 1-0 Omaha right now. He goes up and gets a pitch high in the zone, and it is drilled to right center. It is going to get to the wall. Extra bases for Champ, so he's not slowing down. As a matter of fact, he's going to third. He took that kind of weird turn there, almost like he was going to round third, but he does get in there with a triple. An RBI triple for Champ Kind. That is a way to start off a ball game. That's something we haven't seen yet. So 1-for-1 with a triple in RBI. What's he going to follow that up with? Well, we'll have to see as he comes back up. Lots of runs already. It's 5-3 Omaha in the third. Champ is going to drill this to right. And it is going to go off the base of that high wall. Good play by the right fielder to get in a strong throw. He's just in ahead of the tag. Double for Champ Kind. So he follows up the RBI triple with a double. And this man is seeing the ball well today. He's been seeing the ball well ever since he got on the scene here at AAA for Omaha. But this game especially. So on the bases, and Valencia is going to come through with an RBI double. That goes to the fence, and Champ Kind will score easily on the play. So Omaha is really doing some damage with the bats so far in this game. Champ Kind scores, and he will be coming up again 2-for-2 now. That triple and the double, and again, looking to see if he can get on base. Heck, maybe he can flirt with a cycle here. Who knows? It's 6-5. The game's close. This ball's hit fairly well to center field. It's carrying back. Oh, it cleared the fence. Home run. Whammy! Solo home run for Champ Kind. First the triple, then the double. Now the home run. 20 points more for him. And he is just a single away from hitting for the cycle now. It is a real possibility as this ball flies out of the ballpark at the 398 sign. Champ Kind on fire. Still his team only up 7-5. This game still in doubt. He's going to have to range to the left field line to make that catch. And another out. So now he gets to go grab his bat and give a shot here at getting the cycle. First, we see what he did in the fifth. We just saw that. He homered. for his third hit of the game. He's done a little bit of everything except get a single, and that would give him the cycle. None of my players have hit for the cycle yet in all my Road to the Show series, and it's not going to happen here. This is a ground ball that looks like a double play. No, he beats it out at first, so at least he will be on base. He avoids the double play by hustling down the line. Next batter, Valencia again, I do believe. He's going to tag this to the gap. Champ Kind flying around. He's going to come around third. He'll easily score. First to home on that one. And he scores a run on Valencia's double. He's hitting extra base hits left and right. Nice job. But Champ Kind is chasing one thing and one thing only here. He wants to hit for the cycle. He can feel it gripping that bat. He can smell it. He can taste it. He wants that cycle. And he's got the bases loaded in an 11-8 game. And he rips this to right center. It's going to go to the fence. And Champ Kind is going to stop it first. He's good there. He wants the cycle. He clears the bases on clearly what should have been a double. But Champ Kind says, nah, I'm good right here. I'm going to stand right here. I've hit for the cycle. All right. So there you go. He passes up a chance at an extra base hit to complete a much rarer feat. I'm thinking the manager will forgive him in this case because that is quite an accomplishment to hit for the cycle, stopping at first base. Hey, he cleared the bases in a bases-loaded situation, and they win 15-8. So, yeah, looks like they're all good. He gets the pat on the back for obviously having one of the games of his life, at least this far in his young career. And no-brainer right here. Champ Kind, he's your player of the game. No hard decision there today. Go with the guy that hit for the cycle. If you're the Kansas City Royals right now, are you salivating at the chance to get this guy in your lineup? I've got to think so. Quite an impressive outing here. He's had the four-homer game, and now this, hitting for the cycle. So he's putting quite a resume together for his minor league career and for his bid to make the majors with the Kansas City Royals. So as we wrap this game up, wow, oh wow, what a performance for Champ Kind. Yeah, hits for the cycle in a 15-8 victory. Look at that box score. He got on base all five times. That's awesome. So there you go, hitting .667, and obviously, we're going to hit a slump at some point, but we're enjoying the ride right now. Hope you are too. Come on back for more Champ Kind in AAA with the Omaha Storm Chasers. We will see you next time. Have a great day. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.